That was fun.
Enough.
That's good. Like the way we just walked, in it.
Huh?
It's kind of the way we just walked, isn't it?
No, this is behind 321.
Oh, what street is this?
I'll tell you in a minute. It's called Boyce.
Oh.
And this one we're turning on is called Rankin.
Oh. There isn't much on this street, is there?
No. Empty lots in Kutsu. And a place for the Jubies to gather.
That place for that what?
For the Jubies.
Oh. Yeah, arguments?
It's right in front of us, right here, about 3-4 blocks down.
What?
The Slammer.
Oh. Gaston County Slammer.
Yep.
It's another place to park if you're coming to an event down here. Because as Brian said, he usually goes, parks out. They usually go, him and his wife usually park over there when they come for the fireworks.
Where, at the Slammer?
Yeah, like there's like a parking lot across the street from there.
Yeah, that's where we were.
Where we walked to?
Yeah, we were walking on those parking lots.
Yeah, people arguing in front of a liquor store is like about as inner city American as it gets. Matter of fact, if there's a liquor store that there's never been an argument in front of, they must be selling some bullshit.
And on today's episode, a living husband with a fatal diagnosis promises to contact his wife from beyond the grave. And then keep that dial right here all evening for more great programming, like the TED Radio Hour at 8, the Moth Radio Hour at 9, and the BBC Arts Hour at 10. And all of that with your host, Bob August.
WFAE invites you to the 25th anniversary celebration of Charlotte Talks with Mike Collins, Thursday, October 12th at Blumenthal's Food Playhouse. Join us to mark the milestone for the show that's become the voice of the region. We'll commemorate 25 years of insightful interviews and engaging conversations. You'll hear from Mike and the entire Charlotte Talks staff, enjoy some live performances, and meet a few special guests. And stay after for the post-show reception. It's Charlotte Talks 25, October 12th at Booth Playhouse. Tickets at WFAE.org.
This is 90.7 WFAE Charlotte, 90.3 WFHE Hickory, and WFAE.org. We're Charlotte's NPR news source. Thanks so much for spending your time with me today. I'm Judith Porter. Until next time, be well. It's 6 o'clock.
From NPR and WBEZ Chicago, this is Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me, the NPR News Quiz. I'm Bill Curtis.
And I'm Peter Sagal. After more than 3 years of our daily lives being turned upside down, science may have discovered the best solution for an airborne pathogen, complete apathy. Well, that's what...
I was going to say that.
Tells us if he still likes that old rock and roll. Spoiler, probably yes. And Bill Curtis decides to release his prized breeding pair of actual news vultures.
You can fly in peace.
Alaska really is getting a moment of respite in the air on our quiz coming up right after this hour's news.
Live. live from NPR News in Washington, I'm Janine Hurst. President Biden pledged support to the people of Florida today during a visit to tour damage from
Hello?
Yeah.
Leaving Gastonia.
Going where?
Home.
Okay.
What you up to?
You'll be home to let the dog out.
Yeah, I'm sure.
What, Rudy, is that a problem?
No, no problem.
Okay, I was going to go to my Ashley's and help her do some stuff with Lori. If it's a problem, I will come home.
No, I should be there within the hour.
Okay. Thank you.
Paxton addressed supporters just days before he's scheduled to appear at the Texas Capitol for an impeachment trial. From member station KERA, Nathan Collins has more.
Collin County Republicans and Ken Paxton supporters gathered at a Labor Day weekend celebration in Plano for hot dogs, hamburgers, and to hear from the suspended attorney general.
Were they motorcycle cops?
No, they were motorcycles, and then there was a meat wagon behind a pack.
Oh. Yeah, a group ride. Nice day to ride a Harley. Right, Daddy?
Yep. Bite. The vouchers let people rent on the private market and pay only a third of their income. But many have been frustrated trying to find a landlord to accept them. And if you can't use a voucher within a set time, you have to give it up. Along with the increase, the Biden administration announced funding for nearly 10,000 more families to have housing vouchers. Only a fraction who qualify actually get them. And the shortage of affordable housing is most severe for low-income renters. Jennifer Lutton, NPR. Washington. And you're listening to NPR News from Washington. The trial of one of Egypt's best-known journalists and democracy rights advocates started today in Cairo. NPR's Aya Batrawi reports Egyptian opposition groups say the trial amounts to political repression.
Hisham Essem is a towering figure in Egypt's liberal circles. For decades, he's been at the forefront of calling for democracy and advocating for media freedoms inside Egypt. The former newspaper publisher and rights advocate was initially detained August 20th and faces several charges, the most serious of which is allegedly insulting and verbally assaulting security forces during interrogation. Outside the courtroom on Saturday, his lawyer Nasser Amin told reporters Essem's launched a hunger strike and that his detention was extended for another week. Essem is currently the spokesperson for the Free Current, a new coalition of mostly liberal groups demanding transparency and legal reforms ahead of Egypt's presidential elections early next year. Aya Batrawi, NPR News, Dubai.
The Nobel Foundation today withdrew its invitation for representatives of Russia, Belarus, and Iran to attend this year's Nobel Prize Award ceremonies in Sweden, this amid criticism. The private foundation that administers the awards says it changed its decision after several Swedish lawmakers said they would boycott this year's ceremonies. This year's Nobel Prize winners will be announced in early October. Former U.S. Ambassador to the U.N. and two-term governor of New Mexico, Bill Richardson, has died at the age of 75. You're listening to NPR News from Washington.
Support for NPR comes from NPR stations. Other contributors include the Doris Duke Foundation, which aims to support the well-being of people and the planet for a more...
There must be one hell of a wreck up there.
I that big old truck over there? Having them a Harley group ride. Huh?
Speech on. Speech off.
Like 35 miles an hour, or 30.
You had it right the first time. I don't know what the problem is.
Hey, probably just a bunch of people and...
Oh yeah, this is the weekend that they're talking about, yeah.
Labor Day. Holiday weekends in warm weather seasons are notorious for traffic like this. hour going like 25. A lot of it is associating it with roads I'm very familiar with and what their speed limits are. Sounds like we're looking for parking at the beach at Ocean Boulevard.
Directions to home.
Daddy, I must tell you the truth here. You must be a very slow learner. That's the only way that would still surprise you. Believe it or not, when people go, those little things that annoy other people about the person that goes, they really miss those.
Yeah, I believe that, because I really did miss Aya.
Yep. That's exactly the example I was thinking of. Like things like this. That's what triggers the static.
Oh, hotel there.
I know. I am. You know, when the lockdowns hit, people missed stuff like this. You know that?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Because people were screwed, Daddy. Yeah, I think the reason there was none of this on the roads during COVID lockdowns is because no one had a job to go to. You know that? Truck.
On the right hand side. State trooper and an ambulance.
Oh wow. Is that a hard brakes making that sound?
No. What?
I thought that was our brakes making that sound, but I don't think it was.
shit. I haven't finished doing what I was doing since I was eating on the hunt. Big dog.
Danny.
Yeah.
I want
that ass. That's as typical mommy as, you know, it's as typical mommy as typical anyone gets. Very typical. Matter of fact, I would be concerned about her if she didn't do that. That's how typical it is. There's just some things, Daddy. Road noise. Bless you, Daddy. Are we on one of those bridges?
No.
Looks like all of Gaston County is going to that game in Charlotte.
It's an accident, bro.
Oh.
It's moving very, very slowly. And one meat wagon, two meat wagon, state patrol. Emerging traffic, so it's just a... lot of people coming from.
What about Tennessee, Nebraska?
The tags on the cars and the trucks.
Oh. Guess where we're going in about 3 months. One of the bridges. that an Indian or a Harley? I think it's a Harley. Tesla. What did you say?
Are we going down to Ray Road?
Yeah.
Thank you. Are you going to be able to carry in your four-pack?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to make sure you put it in the fridge?
Yeah.
Okay. I have to piss again. I'll bring the pizza in and put it in the fridge.
Okay.
Deal?
Yeah. Crowded.
Nope. You going for a walk?
Yeah.
10 after 7.
Huh?
It's about 10 after 7.
Oh shit, no. It gets pretty desolate around this time. Tired of my people downtown being sketchy perverts here. right, but this place is not immune to it either.
No, it's not immune. The chances are less likely.
But you know what the wild animals say when think when they see me walking around? Food.
Drastic, but, you know.
What?
Let's go.
Handle
a little tiny thing for your finger to go through.
Right there. I don't think mommy understands. It feels safer downtown to me. Huh? You in, Daddy?
Yes, Mommy, he's there.
Hey, Mommy. They are definitely having the, karaoke thing. Huh? Would you please come with us to that?
Huh? Come say hello to your brother.
Hey, dude.
Hey, Joe.
What you up to?
Oh, I'm just laying in bed. I just woke up.
Oh, what you doing today?
I'm going out to town.
Oh, that's cool. I just got back from Gastonia.
Gastonia? What's in Gastonia?
A brewery that I like.
All the way out there?
Yeah, they got cowboy water and they got crazy pizza. And you could drink downtown there, like on the street.
They pretty have crazy pizza beer.
Yeah, like this place has cheeseburger pizza and spicy pizza, like sriracha and pepper jack cheese and onions and jalapenos. And their crust is so good.
Sounds yummy.
Yep. And they support Los Chuecos.
I think this is your driver's license.
Really now, Joe?
Yep. I love you too, dude.
All right. You have a good day, okay, honey?